काम करने के लिए है।
इज इट पॉसिबल टू डिलीवर?
यस
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 साधु संग और जो हरि कथा है क्योंकि स्वर्ग में भी ये कथा नहीं क्योंकि ये कथा ब्रह्मलोक में भी नहीं ये वैकुंठ में भी कैलाश में भी भगवान की कथा नहीं।
श्रुति गोस्वामी इज सेइंग टू नारद महाराज इन श्रीमद् भागवतम दैट दिस कथा इज नॉट अवेलेबल इन द हेवनली प्लैनेट्स इट नॉट अवेलेबल इन द ब्रह्मलोक इट्स नॉट अवेलेबल इन द वैकुंठ आल्सो इट्स नॉट अवेलेबल एनीवेयर बट हियर।
जब देवताओं को भी कथा सुनना हो तो स्वर्ग से उतर करके किसी मरते जगत में कथा सुनने के लिए आते हैं। अगर ब्रह्मा जी को कथा सुनना हो तो ब्रह्म लोग छोड़ करके शंकर जी को हो तो शिव लोग छोड़ कर गरुड़ जी को हो तो वैकुंठ छोड़ कर किसी मरते जगत में कथा सुनने आते
हैं। When Brahmaji wants to hear Harikatha, then he comes from Brahmaloka to hear Harikatha on this planet. When Shankarji wants to hear Katha, then he comes from his Kailash and he comes and hears Harikatha here. When Garudi wants to hear Harikatha, he leaves back on the planet and comes here to hear Harikatha. It's such a greatly fortunate day for all of us. That which is rare for even the highest of the demigods in the universe, we are getting a chance so easily to sit here, gather together and hear this Harikatha. You must clap your hands that you are hearing this Harikatha.
Although
Shri Raghunath Das Goswami is an eternal associate of the Lord, but in certain circumstances we also understand that in Krishna's pastime sometimes he is referred to as the Pratimanjari, sometimes he is referred to as Rasamanjari, sometimes as Bhanumati Sakhi. So a question may arise here that how come these all three names are mentioned about Shri Raghunath Das Goswami? He can either be one of them, but he cannot be all three. This question arises. So, how do you consider this, that all these three are within, we are referring to Raghunath Das Goswami? He is describing, just like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he is complete, Sampur, he is complete, that he is Krishna also, he is Radharani also, Nrsimha Bhagavan is within him, Lord Narayan is within him, like this all the incarnations are within him. Similarly, all his associates also, they also have all the incarnations, or they are also the embodiment of all the incarnations of his devotees, like Sati, Manjari, Rasamanjari, etc.
Yeah, that is the Rai Ramananda program there. The Rai Ramananda me, that he is the Visakha hai hai. Rai Ramananda hai hai. Kukande Lalitati hai. Arjuna Sakhi bhi hai. Arjuna hai. Sabke Rai Ramananda under me. This is the Raghunath Das Goswami under me. सबके सब एक साथ में हो करके महापुरुष का रस का आस्वादन करते
हैं। Just like it is mentioned about Rayavanan and also that he is Vishaka Sakti, also he is Velda Sakti and also he is mentioned as Sati, and also mentioned that Arjun is all within him. Similarly, Raghunath Das Goswami also, he is also the embodiment of all these three that you mentioned earlier.
इसलिए कहते हैं कि ये रघुनाथ दास गोस्वामी जितना प्रतिवादी करेंगे क्योंकि जो चिरादिन महोत्सव है इसमें आप लोग सब जानते हैं सब कैसे लोग गुरुदेव का तो शिष्य है सब कैसे पुराना है लेकिन ये जब बारंबार घर द्वार छोड़ करके महाप्रभु के पास में जाना चाहते थे हैं लेकिन साधारण लोग जो तो भावना है ये भक्ति कौन करता है हमारे भारत में विशेष करके बोले जिसको पैसा इनकम का कोई उपाय नहीं मिलता है हैं और कोई अच्छा कोई काम धंधा नहीं करते सब शारीरिक बस साधु बन जाते हैं और अपना जीविका निर्वाह करते हैं ऐसे नहीं यदि जितने महापुरुष का परिचय अगर देखने मिले तो उस सब के सब राजा लोग थे वो साधारण नहीं थे सनातन गोस्वामी तो प्राइम मिनिस्टर थे विष्णु गोस्वामी तो फाइनेंस सेक्रेटरी थे श्री नरोत्तम दास आचार्य स्वयं राजा के बेटे थे और रघुनाथ दास गोस्वामी ये कहते थे जिसके घर में इंद्र के बराबर ऐश्वर्य और पत्नी अप्सरा जैसे सुंदर थे
All of you here, I can see, Maharaj is that all of you I can see are Buddha's disciples, and all of you know the pastimes of Raghunath Das Goswami. You are familiar with Raghunath Das Goswami and his personality. He's saying we also know that he is the eternal associate of the Lord. And generally, we see that in India, especially, we see that a person who is not successful in his business, who is not successful in his material life, usually it is them who come to the temple, who, they leave everything that, okay. I'm not successful in material life, so they come and join the temple. This is general behavior. This is general behavior of people we see in India. But he's saying that all the associates of Mahaprabhu, actually, they were no ordinary people, even materially. We see that they were all very exalted personalities, even in the material world. And we know about Sanatana Goswami Pad, that he was the Prime Minister, and then Rupa Goswami Pad, he was the Finance Minister, and Narottam Das Thakur, who was he? He was the son of a king himself, he was the prince himself, and Raghunath Das Goswami himself, it is described that he was described in Sanatana Goswami that his father had the opulence equal to the opulence of Indra of the heavenly planets, and his wife, it is described that she was prettier than the many heavenly dancers. So this was the opulence of Shri Raghunath Das Goswami.
इसलिए श्री दुर्गा मंगल ठाकुर कहते हैं अगर इसके जीवन में एक कृष्ण भक्ति की एक बूंद अगर इसके रस के आस्वाद में विषय हो जाए तो जो विश्व ब्रह्मांड का सारी संपत्ति उसके सामने खिचड़ी हो जाती है इसलिए एक श्लोक में कहते हैं कहते अमृतम अमृतम असी बोले अमृत तो मर जा तेरे तरफ में कोई देखेगा नहीं बोले द्राक्षा रस अंगूर रस को द्राक्षा रस के तौर तेरे तरफ कोई देखेगा नहीं है इसलिए वहाँ पर कहते हैं सरकरे करते साक्षी सरकरे तुम कर्ता सो तुम करवा हो गए क्यों राधा कृष्ण का प्रेम रस जब आस्वाद में होता है तब दुनिया की सारी जितने आनंद उसके सामने खुल जाते हैं
सो सो बिल्वा मंगल ठाकुर इज डिस्क्राइबिंग दैट हाउ व्हेन somebody gets a taste of a single drop of the ocean, from the ocean of bhakti, from the nectar of bhakti, if he gets a taste of, if he is able to get a single drop from this ocean of bhakti, then it is sufficient for him to lose interest in all the material pleasures. Like he's describing, Lord Mahaprabhu is describing that the most sweet nectar of juice is essentially the juice of the grapes. He's saying that this also becomes like tasteless. And the sugarcane juice is considered to be very sweet as well. And he says that this also becomes tasteless. So all material amrit, he's saying that amrit means that which gives you immortality. He says, nectar of immortality, may you die. Means it, the one who is giving us life, making us immortal, he's saying, you also may die. Why? Because when somebody gets a taste from the ocean of the bhakti ras, even a single drop of that he gets a taste, then everything else becomes insignificant or tasteless also, of course.
इसलिए तेरे रघुनाथ दास गोस्वामी जब उन्हें बारंबार सब संपत्ति को छोड़ करके जा रहे थे तब उनको और उनको बारंबार पकड़ कर ला रहे थे इतने में उनको माता जी कह रहे हैं उसको पिताजी बोले क्या कर रहे हो तुम बार बार उसको पकड़ करके लाते हो एक काम करो लोहे की जंजीर ला उसका हाथ पैर को बांध कर पटक देते हो बार बार घर कर तब उनको पिताजी कहते बोले पागली जगत में अगर दो चीज जगत में जो भी जीव को संसार में बांध कर रखती एक पैसा और एक बीवी पत्नी ये दो चीज जो जगत में इसको बांध के रखने वाले यही दो चीज है, लेकिन हमारे घर में परिपूर्ण रूप में वो चीज है साक्षात जीवन का ये प्रण है। जो ये जीवन का बंधन नहीं रक्षा कर सके ये जड़ बंधन लोहे की जल्दी सबको क्योंकि महाबुद्धा जो प्रेम में पागल होता है जो महाबुद्धा प्रेम में पागल है उसको कौन जगत में बांध सकता।
So Ronaldo, some of you know from you have heard this fascinating story that how Ronaldo saw him, although designing the home, but again and again he signed to escape from his home. Again and again he signed to escape, and there are many servants in the home, many security guards, etc. in the home, his father and his uncles have. Every time they get him chased and they bring him back. Every time he runs away, every time they chase him, catch him and they bring him back. Then his mother says to her husband, means she says to Ramananda also from his father, she's saying, mother saying to the father, what are you doing? Just bind him in some iron chains and put him away in a corner so that he's never able to run away. And she's saying, Ramananda also from his father said, oh, you foolish woman, you do not understand. He's saying, there are two very strong bonds in this world. There are very two strong, very attachments in this world, which shackles in this world, which nobody is able to break from. One, the material opulences, the wealth, and second, the beauty of a woman. He's saying he has both these in ample amounts. He has the best of the women, most beautiful of the woman as his wife, and we have opulence like compared to Indra. He has all these things, but still he is running away. If these cannot bind him, if these bindings are not strong enough for him, what these iron chains, iron shackles will do? So he's describing that how he's describing that one who gets a taste, he is able to relish the association of Mahaprabhu. After that, everything else in the material world becomes insignificant or tasteless for him.
जब उनको पता चला श्री नित्यानंद प्रभु आए हैं तब उसी समय उन्होंने दर्शन करने के लिए जब दर्शन करने के लिए गए तो महा नित्यानंद प्रभु को दूर से देख करके तब उनको चोर बोले, बोले चोर बड़े दिन में तुम पकड़ में आए जरा तेरे को भी मैं देता हूँ हैं। तब जब श्री श्री रघुनाथ दास गोस्वामी गए उनके चरणों में प्रणाम किया बोले प्रभु मुझे क्या दंड देना चाहते हैं अरे तुमका दंड है सारे भक्तों को चिड़ा देती महोत्सव चिड़ा तो सब ठीक चिड़ा इसलिए यहाँ पर कहते भक्ति जगत में जो दंड भी है ना ये भी बड़ा मीठा है दंड मतलब पहले समझ लेकिन यहाँ पर भक्ति
जगत
हाँ यहाँ पर जो दंड है ठीक चिड़ा तो बड़े खुश होकर भक्ति बात वैष्णव सेवा करें तो बड़े खुश हो।
So like this, he is trying to escape every time. And one day he heard that near his home there is a place called Panipuri. And in that he heard that Srila Nityananda Prabhu had come with his associates. That time Ramananda Das Goswami, accompanied by the security guards of his father, he was accompanied by them and he goes to that place. And from a distance, he is paying obeisances to Srila Nityananda Prabhu. When Nityananda Prabhu saw him from a distance paying obeisances, then he called him in both teeth. He called him, oh, sure, come here. He said, you have been trying to steal my wealth without my permission. Come here because you have committed a criminal offense. I have to punish you. So what punishment he gave? Ramananda Das Goswami came closer to him. He bowed down, he touched his feet, and he asked him, what punishment do you deem fit for me? He said, your punishment is that you have to feed chipped rice, yogurt, and condensed milk to all the devotees who are present here. So and this is the punishment in spiritual life. It is not a punishment really. Actually, he is giving him seva, service to so many Vaishnavas. Even the punishment in the Vaishnava world, devotee's world is sweet. एक स्वरूप में राधा रानी का जो निकुंज
अत्यंत निकट जाकर सेवा करने वाले कौन लोग होते हैं। और दूसरा स्वरूप हम कहते हैं ये नित्यानंद अभिन्न श्री रूपात
There are many teachings, many lessons from this pastime. He's saying, one of the teachings is that he is, when he sees Raghunath, right, he's seeing Raghunath Das Goswami from a distance and he is calling off him, he is calling him a thief. What does it mean, thief? And why is he mentioning him to him as a thief? He's describing that how, who is a thief? The definition of a thief is somebody who is stealing away your property. And he's gone away without your permission, taking away the property that belongs to you. Such person is defined as a thief. So he's saying now, Raghunath Das Goswami, what is he doing? He's trying to take Krishna, he's trying to bring Krishna into his life. Who does Krishna belong to? Krishna belongs to Guru Pada. It is described that in the Sarasvati Thakur's morning prayer, what we've seen earlier, So in this shloka he is describing that who is Gurudev? Gurudev, he said, one is he is not different from the expansion of Nityananda Prabhu himself. He is Guru Paramatma. He is Guru Paramatma. He comes as a non-different form Nityananda Prabhu. Another form is that he is performing very near intimate services to the Lord in his Nikunja, to Radha and Krishna. So these are two of his forms. So he's again a question may arise here that so we are speaking that Gurudev is not different from the temple in one form and in another form he is serving Radha and Krishna intimately in their Nikunja pastimes. So question may arise here that so all the gurus are to be considered to be that they are serving Radha Krishna in Nikunja pastimes and in expansion from Nityananda Prabhu. He's saying no, He's saying, who is Radha Rani? Radha Rani, by her name itself, you can understand, somebody who is performing with all her mind, body, so everything that there is that belongs to Radha Rani, actually it is in service of Krishna. That's why her name is Radha. Radha means somebody who is performing Aradhana, worship to Krishna in a most special, significant way. So this is Radha Rani, and who is Baladev? Baladev Prabhu is one who is performing in five ras and ten. In five ras and ten forms, in ten expansions, ten forms, he is serving Krishna. So this should be if he has the Gurudev has this ideals in his life, he has adopted these ideals, this worship of the way of Radha Rani and the way Balaram Prabhu is serving. Then you can understand that he is non-different from such a Gurudev. Otherwise, not all Gurudevs are be considered as non-different from these servants of Radha and
Nityananda Prabhu. हमें तो कांगाल कृष्ण कृष्ण बोले धाई तो भक्तों का कह रहे हैं कृष्ण किसके हैं बोले कृष्ण से तुम्हार मुझे कृष्ण वैष्णव होता है राधा कृष्ण वैष्णव होता है जब उनका हृदय की संपत्ति वो चाहे तो कर सकते हैं अगर उनको बिना बोले अगर कोई देना चाहे तो छोड़ दे.
So he is saying further that Krishna, who does it belong to? Radha and Krishna, who does it belong to? Actually, it is described that he is the property of the Vaishnavas. The Vaishnavas reside in the heart of Krishna. He is their wealth. That if you want to take Krishna, Dhai Kavai Pache Pache, this Bhutana Thakur's bhajan is describing, to get Radha and Krishna.
Krishna
said, Tomar. Krishna said, Tomar. Krishna Nita Paro means, you are able to give me Radha and Krishna. Otherwise, I am a pauper. I am just a beggar. And so, it is your property. So, when it is their property, then if they will desire, then when they will want to give, then they can give. So, it means that we have to approach Gurudev in a humble manner and ask them when they are ready to give, when they will give their wealth, which is desiring in their heart. Then we can understand that they will give us on their own. Yeah.
इसलिए और उनको कहते चोर है, बोले जब चोर है फिर क्या बोले दंड दूंगा, बोले दंड क्या है, बोले वैष्णव सेवा कर, वैष्णव का सेवा कर, और यहाँ पर दंड तो उसने वैष्णव सेवा क्यों बताई, भक्तों का सेवा के लिए क्यों नहीं बताया.
So this is what has happened now, that and now Raghunatha Goswami, what has he done? Because if Radha and Krishna are the property of the Vaishnavas and they reside in the heart of the Vaishnavas, so then what is Raghunatha Das Goswami doing? Raghunatha Das Goswami is trying to approach Radha and Krishna directly. So, but it is the property of the Gurudev. Bhutanand Prabhu has come there, appeared as Gurudev. He is performing pastimes of our Guru work. So that's why he is saying that he has called him and he is saying, because you have been a thief and you have behaved as a thief, so I give you punishment. And what punishment is he giving? He is giving punishment, go and serve the Vaishnava. So question may arise that one, he is calling him a thief, and second, he is giving service to all the Vaishnavas. So why is he giving service to the Vaishnavas? Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Sri Goswami Prabhupada, on this question, he has written a very elaborate commentary. We should all try to understand what Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Sri Goswami Prabhupada spoke about this.
गुंडीचा मंदिर मार्जन लीला में उन्होंने दिखाया. गुंडीचा मंदिर जिस समय महाप्रभु सारे परिकरों को लेकर के गुंडीचा मंदिर मार्जन कर रहे थे, कुछ लोग थे काम चोर जो सही सही मंदिर मार्जन नहीं कर रहे थे. महाप्रभु देख रहे थे, इसलिए जो सही सही काम नहीं कर पा रहे थे महाप्रभु बोले तो तुम काम चोर हो, इसलिए जो यहाँ पर काम चोर करेगा उसको भी मैं दंड प्रदान करूँगा. हाँ, दंड दूंगा. वहाँ पर भी महाप्रभु बोले, वहाँ पर भी क्या दंड देंगे, बोले वैष्णव सेवा.
In describing about this, he is elaborating a pastime that we have heard so many times about Gurudev Mandir Maharajan, the cleaning of the Gurudev Mandir. He is describing that how when Mahaprabhu, along with so many of his followers, he is in this pastime of cleaning the temple. When the temple is being cleaned, he notices that there are some Vaishnavas, some people are there who are actually being lazy, and who are trying to not work as hard as others are working, and they are trying to waste time here and there. And that time also, Mahaprabhu stopped them, and Mahaprabhu called them. And Mahaprabhu said to them that, oh, you are not working. You are not working properly. You are not working at all. So I must give you punishment. There also Mahaprabhu says, because you are not working properly, I will give you a punishment. He said, what punishment he gives? I ask you to serve the Vaishnavas. And then?
यहाँ पर प्रभुपाद कहते हैं ये तुमने महाप्रभु से क्यों बताया कि वहाँ पर बोले देखो कौन कितना सेवा कर रहा है मंदिर में, एक साल से खुला पड़ा रहता है, इसलिए कैसे पता चलेगा कौन कितना सेवा किया कितना वहाँ खुला रहा. बोले जब हम झूला को एक टका हम देखेंगे ना, उससे पता चलेगा कौन कितना साफ किया है. जिसका झूला ज़्यादा होगा पता चलेगा उसने बढ़िया सेवा किया, जिसका झूला कम होगा मतलब तुमने काम करो, इसलिए उसका हम दंड देंगे. तो उन्होंने सबके सब एक कर दिए, क्या तो महाप्रभु जितने और सारे भक्त लोग थे सबके जो धुला को एक कर दिए, तो वो महाप्रभु का धुला जो एक कर जाए जन तो महाप्रभु का धुला ज्यादा सबके सबके मिला कर, तो बोले इसका मतलब क्या है, महाप्रभु का इतना सेवा किया और वहाँ अद्वैत आचार्य और वहाँ पर श्री गादाधर पंडित श्री वास अरे भक्त कितने सारे भक्त है, तो महाप्रभु का इतना ये क्या तो इतना ज्यादा इसका मतलब क्या.
So, and then he's describing that Mahaprabhu, how did he find out that who is working and who is not working properly? He said, what is happening here? This is Gurudev Temple. Mundis temple remains closed for an entire year. Only once in a year it is open, when Lord Jagannath comes from the main temple and then he resides there for a few days. So when before Lord Jagannath has to come, this temple is clean and it is made fit for the Lord to come and arrive there and have a seating place for a clean seating place for a few days. Now, how to understand somebody who is working properly or not? He said, it is so dusty, this place. It is so dusty. So everybody who is cleaning, they are collecting the dust in a pile. In a pile, they are collecting the dust. So if you look at the piles of all the people that they have collected, by that you can understand, if somebody has a very small pile, you can understand that this person hasn't worked properly. But somebody has a bigger pile, you can understand that this person has worked properly. So now, it is seen that all the devotees present there, they have swept there, and after sweeping, they have collected the piles of dust. Now, everybody has collected the piles of dust by how much they have worked, they have collected in front of them. Now it is seen that all those devotees who have worked, they have collected these piles of dust, but the pile of dust that is collected by Mahaprabhu and all the piles of dust that the other devotees have collected together could not be equal to the pile of dust that is collected by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So what does it mean? And what does it signify? What does it mean there? That who were present there, who were working with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? It means that other people were not working properly. Other people were just wasting time. Who was present there? There were Dharadhar Pandit. There were Advaitachar, such exalted devotees. So what does it mean? That why does Mahaprabhu have such a big pile, huge pile? And why do others have a smaller pile? Yeah. So, where is this fascinating being performed of cleaning the temple? This is Gundicha. Gundicha means understand that it is play pastime of the Lord and Radharani. And it is there now who is serving there? Mahaprabhu himself is serving there. Who is cleaning? Mahaprabhu himself is serving. And who is Mahaprabhu? Mahaprabhu is serving in the mood of Radharani. Mahaprabhu is serving in the mood of Radharani, and Radharani, we know, her name is Radha. Radha means somebody who is performing special sarana to the God. And the way Radharani can serve, the way Radharani can fulfill the desires of the Lord, and the way Radharani can make arrangements, preparation, etc. in the Nikum for the Lord, who is coming here in the temple, in this temple? Jagannath means Krishna himself. If he is coming and Radharani is serving, is there anybody in this entire universe who can be a better servant than Radharani? Because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is serving the mood of Radharani herself. So of course, her pile is much bigger than all the rest of the devotees combined.
इसलिए जो बढ़िया से साफ कर रहा था महाप्रभु तो बहावा दे रहे फिट पर हाथ तो बढ़िया साफ क्या मंदिर साफ किया लेकिन जो नहीं कर पा रहा तो उनको मीटिंग की गाली दे रहे मीटिंग की गाली दे रहे तो बोले देखो और जो बढ़िया के नहीं कर रहा था उसको बोले देखो बहुत बढ़िया के नहीं किया तो दूसरे को सिखा तो प्रभुपाद इसका मतलब क्या है जो बढ़िया के नहीं कर रहा मतलब जो अच्छे तरह से अपना हृदय को साफ कर रहा है भजन कर रहा है भैया तुम स्वयं अपना हृदय को साफ कर भजन करे तो दूसरों को भी भजन की शिक्षा दो दूसरों को भी भजन की शिक्षा दो क्यों तुम अच्छे तरह से अपना हृदय क्लीन कर रहे अच्छे तरह से साफ कर रहे इसलिए जो स्वयं साफ नहीं कर सकता तो तुम दूसरों को क्या बताएंगे इसलिए तो तुम दूसरों को भी शिक्षा दो
So what is happening there in this pastime? This is telling that how, what does it mean, this cleaning of the temple? What does this pastime signify? This pastime signifies that you are not cleaning the temple actually you are cleaning your hearts. Cleaning your hearts means this dust actually signifies the dirt, the the desires that are separate from service of Radha and Krishna, this is what ignorance is. So when they are cleaning the temple and they are collecting dust, and somebody who has not collected much dust, his pile is very small, means he's not able to clean his heart very well, and he's giving the punishment. And what is Mahaprabhu doing to such people? He's giving them some sweet abuses. Sweet abuses, harsh abuses, but sweet abuses. That means he's speaking some sarcastic words to them and all. And those who are collected big piles, you can see, and he appreciates them. And he sees that, oh, how nicely you have cleaned the temple. How wonderfully you have done this service. Means, what it means? It means that you are performing good by them. And you are cleaning your heart very nicely because of your sincere absorption in Bhajan. You are cleaning your heart nicely. And then he says to him, to such people, he says, oh, you are cleaning very nicely. You are cleaning very nicely. Go and help others also. Go and help guide others also. How to clean this temple like the way you have cleaned. Means, when you are performing Bhajan, then your heart is purified. When you are performing Bhajan, your heart is purified. And how you perform Bhajan, similarly, you should teach others also who are not able to clean themselves, clean their hearts on their own by their own strength. They should take guidance from the others who have cleaned their hearts nicely, who have performed their Bhajan nicely, so that they will also be able to perform their Bhajan properly.
जैसे हमने कुछ पैसा कमा रहे, अगर पैसा को अगर तुम अपना सेवा में लगाओगे तो तुम्हारा संस्कार था, तुम कमा रहे हो अपना सेवा में लगा रहे, एनर्जी लगा रहे पैसा में, पैसा लगा रहे एनर्जी में, भक्ति में तो एनर्जी नहीं, पैसा में कमा रहे, वो पैसा जब कुछ हो गुरु वैष्णव भगवान की सेवा में लगेगा क्या होगा, फिर तुम्हारी सुकृति बढ़ेगी, फिर सुकृति जब बढ़ेगी फिर तुम भजन में घूम रहे। इसलिए महाप्रभु कह रहे हैं जो हृदय को साफ नहीं कर रहे, भजन नहीं कर रहे।
So then, what is he saying to these people? What punishment is being given to these people who are not able to collect big piles, means who are not able to perform properly, who are not able to clean their heart properly? So what punishment is he giving them? He's giving them this punishment that, oh, you should serve the other Vaishnavas. What does it mean, serve the other Vaishnavas? Serve the other Vaishnavas, and what does it signify? He's saying, in our daily lives, we see that we work hard day and night. Now, if you work hard day and night, you're making money. When you make money, you spend all this money on your own. So what do you get from this? Nothing. You're just creating more and more actions and reactions you're creating for yourself. And how will you come out of this cycle of action and reaction? He's saying, if you utilize some of this money, all of this money that you have collected, your daily work, routine, etc., and you use this for the service of any guru and Vaishnava, then you collect something. Then you collect something. Similarly, now, why? Because this person is not able to perform bhajan. So what instruction Mahaprabhu is giving? Go and serve the other Vaishnavas. So by serving the other Vaishnavas means either by money you are earning to serve, or by you go and serve the Vaishnavas. So actually, by whatever efforts you have like to perform, you are collecting sukriti. So in a way, when you will be able to collect sukriti for yourself, then you will be able to perform your bhajan better. This is the meaning of giving this as punishment, then go and serve the Vaishnavas.
रघुनाथ दास स्वामी बोले क्या बोले वैष्णव सेवा कर अरे जय राधा बिन बिहारी देव की
जय
गुरु पार्वती की
जय
जगन्नाथ महाप्रभु की
जय प्रेमंदे हरि हरि बोल
हरे कृष्ण इसलिए इसलिए रघुनाथ दास स्वामी बोले ऐसा वैष्णव सेवा कर रघुनाथ रघुसो बहुत वैष्णव सेवा कर नाव में बैठ के चिड़वा केला वहाँ के संदेश और वहाँ की जो दही दूध उन्होंने खूब मंगवाया मंगवा करके उन्होंने दो तरह का चिड़ा था उस तरफ में इसका बहुत बंगाल उड़ीसा बिहार ये तीनों स्थान पर इसका बड़ी प्रसिद्ध है चिड़वा दही एक में चिड़वा दही एक में चिड़वा दूध और इसमें केला संदेश और आम का समय अभी आम का सीजन इसमें बढ़िया आम उधर बड़ी आम मिलता है मिला कर बढ़िया उन्होंने चिड़ा दही बनाया और महाप्रभु जगन्नाथ को युवराज मंगल और महाप्रभु के लिए आसन दिया महाप्रभु स्मरण किया तो महाप्रभु ने वहाँ पर स्वयं प्रकट हुए और सब कुछ ग्रहण किया सारे वैष्णव लोग ग्रहण करके हरे खुश हो गए खुश होकर के नित्यानंद प्रभु उनकी श्री रघुनाथ दास गोस्वामी सर पर तैयार रखा और आशीर्वाद दिया सब वैष्णव लोग प्रसन्न बताए वैष्णव का हृदय में ठाकुर का निवास फिर वैष्णव खुश हो गए ठाकुर अपने खुश हो गए फिर उसको बाद में फिर से छोड़ दिया
बाद में अनदर कॉपी सो ही इज सेइंग दैट हाउ this now Raghunandas Swami has been given this punishment by Nityananda Prabhu that you serve all the vaisnavas means he has been given a chance to earn all sukriti so what is that what did he do he belongs to a very wealthy family so when he was told to serve all the vaisnavas go and feed them a feast so in Bengal Orissa etc Bihar in this eastern states of India this chip rice and mixed with either condensed milk or with yogurt it is very popular very popular. So what he did, he called boatloads and boatloads of banana, of mangoes, because in India at the moment it is mango season. Banana season is 12 months in India. So he called for all bananas, loads and loads of bananas, loads and loads of mangoes, and milk, and chip rice, and sandesh. Sandesh is a sweet made up of condensed milk also. And he made two sorts of preparations. One he makes with yogurt, and another he mixed with milk, and mango, and banana, and sandesh. And like this he divided, and he very happily, that what a wonderful punishment I got, very happily he is serving all the devotees. And when all the devotees are being served, then one asana, sitting place was also made for Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Where is this is being performed in Bengal, this asana? But, and where is Mahaprabhu? Mahaprabhu is in Puri that time. But it was seen by some devotees, it was seen that Mahaprabhu came there, he accepted whatever was offered to him, and then all the devotees also very satisfied. And when all the devotees are very satisfied, then Radha Krishna satisfied them automatically themselves. And so all the devotees are satisfied, and Mahaprabhu is satisfied, Nityananda Prabhu is happy, and Nityananda Prabhu called Raghunath Das Goswami, and he put his foot on the head of Raghunath Das Goswami. And that time, by the strength of Nityananda Prabhu's blessing, that time after that when we tried very easily we went away to Puri and there was no obstacle on his part.
They got Mahaprabhu pass me last time to leke aate the chali aati last time to unhone aaye kahe to unko koi remedy to koi nahi hai to nahi hai fir sai vishnu ka kripa ho gayi fir ji ko to ho gayi nitanand durga guru ka kripa ho gayi unke kripa ke bagair to radha krishna bhi nahi sakte nitai karna ab brij radha krishna इसलिए वास में लास्ट फिर कोई लेने नहीं आए महाप्रभु बोले जब उन्होंने विषय छोड़ कर के आए तो महाप्रभु कहते हैं महाप्रभु कहते हैं तुम्हारे पर ठाकुर का बड़ी कृपा है ये विषय नहीं है बीस है विषय की विष्ठा है इसलिए तुमने विषय की बीस को छोड़ करके आए हो विष्ठा को छोड़ करके आए हो बड़ी कृपा तुम्हारे पर करोड़ों जन्म का संस्कार होने पर तभी कोई विषय को छोड़ सकते हैं तो छोड़ सकते
Then, so when he got the blessings of Nityananda Prabhu, then before this he had tried to escape several times, but every time he was caught and he was brought back to the home. But this time, when he attempted to escape, he was given intelligence enough in his heart how to do, what path to take, and also there were no obstacles raised on his path. And he reached Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's lotus feet. When he reached Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's lotus feet, then Mahaprabhu told him, he's saying, "Oh, you are so fortunate that you have been able to escape from the shackles of the material world. Because this material world is vish. This vishaya means the material world, and vish means poison." He's saying, "This material world is vish, it is poison. And only by the sukriti collected from past millions of lives, a person is able to leave this material attachments and all, material shackles and all. And now because he had sukriti had matured, and by this mature sukriti of his serving all the devotees, all the vaisnavas, his sukriti matured, and he was able to very easily escape to Puri and stay with Mahaprabhu in his association and the associates' association.
How long? Harikatha? It's 7:25.
You can go on Maharaj, go to 8 if you want.
Time to act on both.
Everyone happy if we go to 8? We'll go 10 to 8 then we'll do arati.
10 to 8.
We'll do 10 to 8 then we'll do arati.
कहते आप लोग तो जानते हो रघुनाथ दास स्वामी के जो वैराग्य है उन्होंने जिस जैसे भी वो भगवान की नित्य सिद्ध कड़ी करे नित्य सिद्ध कड़ी कर उन्होंने जो साधारण एक दिन कैसे धीरे धीरे भक्ति में उन्होंने प्राप्त करे तो स्वयं अपना जीवन उतार कर उन्होंने एग्जाम्पल रखा है कैसे भक्ति करनी चाहिए, मैंने कैसे उन्होंने जब कैसे उनको पिताजी जब देखा पिताजी कुछ छोड़ कर चला गया, पिताजी ने नौकर में भेज दिया और उसे बनाए स्नान करा कि राजा का अवसर देते और कुछ धन दौड़ के भेज दिया, लेकिन कुछ दिन के लिए तो व्यवहार किया लेकिन महाप्रभु ने उसको रिजेक्ट कर दिया।
So now, Raghunath Das Goswami has escaped Puri and he is now staying with Mahaprabhu and his associates. When he started staying there, but actually he doesn't belong to the Pandit family. He belongs to a family which has princely wealth and he belongs to such a family, so his father sent some servants to take care of him. He also sent some money for him to utilize for his stay when he is staying in Puri. So Raghunath Das Goswami utilized that money. Actually, who is Raghunath Das Goswami? Raghunath Das Goswami is an eternal associate of the Lord. He is serving the Lord in different ways, different forms, in different planetary systems. He is serving the Lord. But although he is an eternal associate, but he here as a sadhak, as a practitioner, he has shown by his ideal behavior how a sadhak, how a practitioner can gradually progress from one step to the other to higher steps. So here, Raghunath Das Goswami, when his father sent some money and his servants, now they are taking care of his bodily needs, his servants are cooking for him, etc. So Raghunath Das Goswami utilized that money, that wealth that was sent by his father, and sometimes he would also send an invitation to Mahaprabhu to whatever he would arrange for cooking, etc., whatever preparations he would make, he would call Mahaprabhu also. And Mahaprabhu used to come and accept whatever invitation he would send, whatever preparations he was making. And after some time, Raghunath Das Goswami stopped calling Mahaprabhu. Why? Because after some time he realized that if I am to be renounced, then I don't have to accept that which has been sent by my father. I have to be renounced in the true manner. So that time he stopped inviting Mahaprabhu. And Mahaprabhu asked one time to his servant that Raghunath Das Goswami hasn't sent me invitation for a long time. He said yes, because he sent his servants and the wealth that was sent by his father back again to his father. And Mahaprabhu became very happy at that.
ऐसे उनके जो वैराग्य है जो सब कुछ छोड़ करके भगवान के ऊपर में शरणागत होकर भक्ति करना चाहते हैं, तो छह तरह का शरणागत में एक शरणागति है भक्ति के वर्णन का, तो भगवान जरूर हमें पालन करेंगे। चिट्ठी से लेकर के हाथी को पालन करते थे भक्ति करने का पालन नहीं था, इसलिए उनको भगवान को संपूर्ण शरणागत होनी चाहिए, शरणागति होनी चाहिए। ऐसे नहीं अपना लिए कुछ बैंक में पैसा डिपोजिट कर ले,
so Raghunath Das Goswami, what is he showing to us now by this passage? He is showing to us that how one of the limbs of surrender is that you should have full faith that Krishna will maintain you in all times, and Krishna maintains you all times. But suppose a devotee decides he wanting to go to Vrindavan, then what arrangements we make? We make a lot of money, then we earn a lot of money, we'll take this money in the and deposit it in the bank in India, and then whenever we'll need something, we'll withdraw the money and utilize for ourselves. Then this is not proper renunciation. The renunciation is shown here by Raghunath Das Goswami. Although in the beginning he accepted the money that was sent by his father, but Raghunath Das Goswami came to this conclusion that no, this is not proper renunciation. That's why after that he rejected that I am going to stay in this dham and I will totally depend on Krishna, whatever he arranges for me. He is maintaining from an ant to an elephant. Nobody is working, nobody has any money in the bank balance, but still all of them are being maintained and all of them are eating every day. All of them are eating and they are surviving. So Raghunath Das Goswami also totally dependent on Krishna now. He sent the wealth of his father back. Okay. Don't get too inspired. He's saying all the Vaisnavas. This is not for the householder. This is for the renounced and sannyasis, etc. Don't get too inspired. It will go away. And the economy of Australia will die tomorrow.
अगर पैसा है, अगर त्यागी वैष्णव है, तो तुमने अपना नाम करना कुछ सेपरेट चीज नहीं रखनी चाहिए। रखनी चाहिए अगर कोई सोसाइटी हो जिसके लिए ठाकुर का सेवा के लिए बैठा, वो ठीक है। जो सेपरेट नेम नाम पर जो रखते हैं वो गड़बड़ी है।
He's saying that who is a renounced person, who is a sannyasi, they should not keep money in their individual names. can he be money in some society which is serving not only himself, it is being used in the service of the temple or of the society. That's proper, but if it is a sannyasi and he collects money and puts money in his bank account in his individual name and utilizing for his individual needs, this is not renunciation, this is not
sannyasi. जो भगवान की सेवा में नहीं लगा करके अपना भोग ही करके लास्ट में सारी ज्यादा करके सब जान कर रहा
है. He's saying that I know so many cases, those so-called sannyasis and all, they go and they collect, they perform some Haikatha, festival, etc., they perform preaching, etc., and by this they collect a lot of money. And all the money that they collect, they put in their banks. And when in the banks, somehow or the other, either the bank or some person, they come and they cheat away that money. And in so many ways I've seen that if you do not utilize the money that has been collected by Bhiksha, by preaching, etc., for the preaching purpose at all, then usually this money actually comes to zero, it comes to naught.
लेकिन उसको बाद में फिर रघुनाथ दास गोस्वामी सिंहद्वार के सामने खड़े होकर के लास्ट में जब वहाँ पर निया में जो प्रसाद बिकता नहीं और बिकने का जो नहीं बिकती है फिर गरीब लोगों को तो ऐसे फिर जीत भर क्या फिर वहाँ पर उसको भी समझा के अपनी बेचा दी जैसे बेचा सोचती है पुरुष आ रही है कुछ देर देखे जाएगी तो दिया नहीं फिर वो दूसरे लोग आ रहे दोनों यही देख रहे हैं फिर ये दूसरों को जो निर्भर करेंगे आ करके देगा तुम्हें कैसे लगेगा ये भी वैसा रूपी महापुरुष को भी रिजेक्ट किया उन्होंने उसको भी त्याग दिया.
So then Raghunath Das Goswami, after that he standing in the front of Narasimha Rao, those who have been to Puri, they know that there is the main entrance of the Puri temple, that is called Narasimha Rao, or the door of the Lord Narasimha. So in front of this door he would stand every day, and then all those people, those who are coming out of the temple, then they would be distributing all those people who are standing there on the side of either side of the path, they will distribute some prasad to them. Then he started waiting for these people who were coming out of the Anand Bazaar, the market where the prasad is being sold, and he would come and they would give him this some food, etc., some prasad they would give him. But Raghunath Das Goswami, after a few days, he again came to this conclusion, this is like the mentality of a prostitute. He's saying a prostitute is every day she's waiting that, oh, will this guy come to me? Will he come to me? Will he give me some money? And similarly, I'm also waiting every day. Will this person give to me? Yesterday he gave me. Will he give me today also? He said, this is not good mentality. And Mahaprabhu also has related. And after that, again, after a few days, then he stopped this and then he stopped. Then he started whatever prasad was completely useless and was actually thrown away in the drains of the nearby the temple. And that prasad, which was smelling, and that prasad which was decaying, that prasad he would collect and he would wash with water and would add some salt and he would start eating that. So then when Raghunath Das Goswami every day he is collecting the grains, etc., from the drains which are getting away from the temple. That time he would collect and wash them and eat them every day. Then Mahaprabhu, one day when he heard that how he is surviving, then Mahaprabhu himself came there and he saw how Raghunath Das Goswami had collected this rice and he was eating. As Raghunath Das Goswami was about to eat, Mahaprabhu held him by the hand and he said that, oh, every day you are eating such wonderful prasad and you are not giving me. Then he ate. He took a bite of this what Raghunath Das Goswami was eating. And that time, second time, he was going to eat, and Sarupnava held him by the hand. He said, oh Lord, no, this is not fit for you. He stopped that from
Mahaprabhu. बोले मैं तो तेरे को दे दिया ना स्वरूप दाम तो मुझे सौ रुपये रघु गए थे तो स्वरूप दाम से मेरे से ज़्यादा जानता है स्वरूप दाम तो कौन है फिर ये कृष्ण ही जान ये ललिता है ललिता से की है इसलिए बोले ये मेरे से ज़्यादा जानते हैं मुझे दे दिया उसको बात मुझे नहीं प्रभु आपका मुँह से मैं कुछ डायरेक्ट इसको शुरू कर सुनना चाहता हूँ तो महाप्रभु उसको पकड़ के चक्कर उन्हें बहुत अच्छी बात उन्हें चार लाइनें बताया अगर चार लाइनें को जीवन बिता दे तो भगवत प्राप्ति.
So after that, some days after Raghunath Das Goswami approached Mahaprabhu and he said that, oh Lord, I want to hear some direct instructions from you to me. I want to hear some direct instructions from your Lord says for me. And then Mahaprabhu said that, but I have already offered you to Sarvananda. Means Raghunath, this Raghunath Das Goswami was known as Sarube Rahu. Sarube Rahu means that Rahu who belongs to Sarvananda. He's saying already I have offered you Sarvananda. So whatever he is instructing you is actually better than my instructions, because who is he? He's Vishakasati. Sarvananda Vishakasati. And Vishakasati, she knows better than me. And whatever instructions Sarvananda is giving, it is even better than instruction that I can give to you. So you should follow. And said, but still Raghunath Das Goswami insisted, please, I want to hear some instruction, personal instruction from your lips for me. Then Mahaprabhu, he gave four lines he spoke, and Maharaj is saying that if somebody were to adopt these four lines, four instructions in their life, understand their life will be successful, and they will very quickly, very easily reach their destination.
महाप्रभु बोले ग्रामे कथा ना सुन वे ग्रामे कथा ना कही वे बाल ना खाई वे और बाल ना बढ़ी वे ब्रजे राधा कृष्ण से मान सकते माँ कहते हैं कहते बहुत बढ़िया बढ़िया भोजन बहुत एक्सपेंसिव बॉडी को भोजन खाते कहते क्यों भोजन नहीं कहते बोले कारण है जितने बढ़िया खाओ तो फिर इंद्रिय उतना तेज हो इंद्रिय तेज होगा तो फिर क्या होगा फिर संसार विषय भोग के लिए अपना आनंद हो मन दौड़ेगा तो फिर तुम विषय भोग
Then Mahaprabhu gave him, first instruction that he gave was, he said that don't eat very rich food and don't wear very nice, like very expensive clothes. You know. Don't spend too much money on your external appearance. Then he's deciding that, oh, what does it mean? He's saying, don't eat very rich food. What does it mean? So, food version of this Sanskrit, Sri Goswami Prabhupada is describing that why we should not eat very rich food. Because when you eat very rich food, your senses will become strong. And when your senses become strong, then they always, the senses are strong, they always run towards the sense objects. And then when you are, your senses are strong, and that time your senses are running towards the sense objects, then all of them, etc., whatever you want to perform, it will be lost. And then secondly, he is describing that do not wear very nicely. Do not take care of too much of your external appearance. He's saying, Srila Sanatana Goswami Prabhupada is describing his commentary. A person who eats very rich food, actually he is destroying his own self. But a person who is wearing very nicely, he not only destroys his own self, actually he destroys the self of the other people also, the mood of the other, mentality of the other people also, who are looking at him. What will happen? See, you are wearing very nicely, and you bought some very nice expensive clothes, etc. And what will you do? You will wear very nice makeup, you wore very nice clothes, and then you're standing in front of the mirror. And then you're turning from this angle. My profile, left profile, right profile. How do I look like this? And then you're watching all this. And then when you go with these clothes and you go outside on the street, what is the mood when you're wearing very, you have worn for the first time very nice clothes? What is the mood when you're walking on the streets? You're walking on the streets, we are now to the corner of our eyes, we are watching. Are they admiring my dress or no? Are they admiring my dress or no? So like this, you will spoil the mood of you, will spoil other persons also, and your own self also will spoil.
ग्राम्य कथा ना सुन ले ग्राम्य वाक्य ना कही कहते जो ग्राम्य कथा है ग्राम्य कथा मतलब क्या है स्त्री पुरुष संबंधित जो कथा है इसको सुनना भी नहीं इसको बोलना भी नहीं इसलिए कहते हैं जितने साधु संघ जितने श्रेष्ठ बताया गया जितने साधु संघ को उन्नत बताया गया असत संघ को भी उतना ही अनर्थ बताया गया इसलिए घर बनाना कितना कठिन तोड़ना आसान से तोड़ सकते इसलिए कहते हैं जितना ग्राम में बात है जो स्त्री पुरुषों से संबंध जो बात अगर सुनोगे आप देखना वो ज्यादा आप जो उसको व्याख्या करवा ज्यादा मन उस तरह फिर भागता है इसलिए कहते ग्राम में कथा में तो सुनना है बात और स्त्री की बात सुनना नहीं और
and do not listen to Ramakatha. Ramakatha here means the topics of the material world, and specifically it is describing the topics of the relationship between a male and female. You say the Sadhu Sangha is considered to be the most exalted destination that a person should desire for. The way it is considered as very esoteric. Similarly, the topics of male and female, between the interaction between male and female, this is considered to be the most desirable. Why? Because he's saying the more you listen to all these topics, the more you will discuss all these topics, the more you speak or listen about these topics, the more your mind will become absorbed in these things. And the more you listen, the more you become absorbed, the farther away it will take you from your real goal. He's saying that do not speak any other topics other than the topics of Krishna. He said only when anyone you meet, tell them about Krishna, hear about Krishna. Tell them about his pastime and read about his pastime. And also he's saying that Madhata Madhata Parasparam Bolende Parasparam. He's saying that how a person who are discussing the pastimes of Krishna and exchanging the pastimes of Krishna between themselves, actually they are totally absorbed in me and they are always in a wonderful, blissful situation. You see? So whomever you meet, whomever you speak to, do not discuss material subjects, do not discuss material objects, do not discuss any sense objects, etc. Speak only Krishna Katha and Krishna pastimes and the devotee's pastimes.
अभी गीता स्थिति नहीं, मानस की सेवा कर सकते, अभी चिंता उस स्थिति नहीं,
कल्पना करके जब संस्कार उसको फिर बनेगा फिर जाकर मानस की सेवा हो सकता है। तो उसके प्रभुपाद की कृपा करके जीवों को ये मंदिर बना के
So it was said by Jnana Mahaprabhu that we should perform manasi seva, the seva of the lordships in our minds. So it was in those times, but not in, it's not referring to the times that we have today. We have temple seva, what do? When we are serving the Lord, we, somebody is a dog there and making some bhoga, and then they are offering to the Lord, and somebody is making a garden, somebody is cleaning the temple, somebody is doing so many other services. They have gone out to the shops and all to buy some boga for the deity. So what all these activities are doing? Actually, because the aim is to serve the Lord. So by all these activities, you collect a lot of security. Before Pujavasya Sanskriti Goswami Prabhupada came on this planet, everybody was doing manasi seva. Means everybody was serving the lordships in their minds. But then Bhakti Sanskriti Goswami Prabhupada saw that the condition, the mental condition of the living entities of the times that are coming, is not fit enough to do manasi seva, to serve the lordships in their minds. That's why they have to do all these activities to the deities, and by collecting supriti over some time, some period of time, then they will become fixed, and then they can perform manasi seva. Means manasi seva cannot be performed unless and until you have had some supriti in your baggage.
Yeah. उनका एक ग्रंथ है जिसका नाम है मनसिक्ख्या। ये मनसिक्ख्या में रघुनाथ दास गोस्वामी को एक श्लोक हम सुनने के लिए कोशिश करेंगे। हम लोग जो रूपानुगत हो गए वैष्णव है, महाप्रभु जो ये रूपानुगत होने के लिए आए, रूपानुगत है क्या जी, और जो ब्रह्मा का एक दिन में एक बार जो प्रेम को देने के लिए आए, जिस प्रेम के लिए ब्रह्मा
to have his mood in this way and he has to serve in this way and he has to discuss in this way.
इसलिए जो पहले है बहुत अच्छा तिथि पहले कहते हैं श्री जगन्नाथ जी की स्नान यात्रा और पूर्णिमा बहुत अच्छा दिन पहले इसलिए हम सब यहाँ यज्ञ भी करेंगे और दोपहर में श्री जगन्नाथ जी को स्नान यात्रा भी हम कराएंगे.
Tomorrow his discharging is a very auspicious day, only very very significant days for our devotion. It is Snan Yatra tomorrow. On Snan Yatra means we will give perform the bath ceremony of the Lord Jagannath. And the Lord Jagannath present himself, he is present here. We will perform this pasha. Before that, in the morning, we will perform the fire yoga.
Maharaj, okay?
Thank you, Maharaj.
Okay. And मैं तुम्हारा कल कल हम जगन्नाथ जी की क्यों जगन्नाथ स्नान करते हैं, स्नान यात्रा के क्या रहस्य है, इसको अंदर में महाप्रभु आकर जो इस विषय पर क्या शिक्षा दिया, महाप्रभु के इस विषय में जो विशेष शिक्षा है उनको सुनकर मैं इसको कल इसको
He saying tomorrow we will try to understand about the significance of this bathing pastime. What is the significance? What are the teachings? Why we perform this pastime? We'll try to tomorrow understand. We'll try to speak something about it.
Okay.
Jagannath
Mahaprabhu ki
jai.
Raghunath Das Goswami ki
jai.
Raghunath Das Goswami ki
jai.
Guru Parampara ki
jai.
Jai.
Gaur Premanande Hari Hari Bol.
Gaur Premanande
Hari Hari Bol.
I've got it.